Hello friends, I welcome you all to my YouTube channel Tarpan Shah, and today I am going to discuss with you all regarding SOP, that's standard operating process for opening a new physiotherapy clinic. Watch this video till the end. I am quite sure it will be helpful to you all. I am going to discuss 15 different steps and that will definitely going to give you some idea about opening of the clinic as well as running a clinic successfully. So let's see the 15 steps. My step number first is to identify your area of interest, which clinic you want to open. Simple or a routine physiotherapy clinic or a specialized clinic like your neuro, cardio, pediatric, women's health, fitness, geriatrics, etc. So identify you are passionate about which domain of physiotherapy that you have to finalize first, and you can open the clinic in the same domain. Step number two, location of the clinic is very extremely important. Choose it very carefully. Ideally, the ground floor with the parking facility in the area which is easily accessible will be very good. And select such a location in your city so that all the people from the different areas, they have an easy access to your clinic. Step number three, identify the need of your service in that area. Okay, so identify whether your services are needed or not. For example, you can't sell ice cream in a cold area. Your sell will always be less or a need. So you need to identify whether physiotherapy treatment is needed or not. If the awareness is less, make it a point clear in your mind that after opening a clinic, you need to work a lot even for generating or creating an awareness as well. Step number four, name of the clinic. It matters, and you have to choose the name very appropriate for your clinic. It can be a simple name, okay, name of your son, daughter, okay, or it can be name of some god or whatever, or it could be a unit which describes your service. Okay, that means after having a look at the name of your clinic, person will get that which type of treatment you are providing. Step number six, make a good logo and register it and use it as a representation of your brand. It's needed, it's required. Okay, so make a good logo. Step number six. Now define as per your need which are the equipment or items you will be required. Okay, if you are opening an orthopedic physiotherapy related clinic, you need an equipment related to orthopedic physiotherapy. Neuro, you need neuro. Cardiopulmonary, you need related to cardiopulmonary physiotherapy. So what you can do is you can make a list for the items or the equipment which is required. First you can make a big list, and then you can segregate that list by based on your need, like orthopedic clinic, okay, these are the basic things I require and these are the special equipment or the items I will be required. So here in this particular slides I have shown you 30 items, okay. Mobile phones, computer with printer and scanner, office furniture, marketing material which is very important, goniometer, sphygmomanometer, chairs, measuring tape, dumbbells, okay, treatment table, stimulator, stools, large mirror, reflex hammer, stethoscope. Okay, starting from there up to the treadmill, all 30 items I have mentioned. Okay, you can add into this list and you can remove some of the things as per the need in your clinic. Okay, but make a list that which are the things will be in a need. Okay, let's see the step number seven. From where to do the purchase of equipment, that is always a big question, and do proper research before you purchase and do a proper negotiation with the person from whom you are purchasing. Ideally, I suggest you to do in-depth R&D, research and development, before you are purchasing any equipment or item for your clinic. So suppose you want to purchase, make a list, divide into electrotherapy, exercise therapy, items which can be purchased from surgical shop, items which can be purchased from local market, and items which can be purchased online. Now after making a list of this, okay, you can ask for the quotations from the different electrotherapy and exercise therapy equipment supplier agencies or the companies. Then you can do a comparison, what are the pros and cons of which company and etc., and then you can finalize, like rather purchasing. Along with that, you do some EMC, annual maintenance contract with them. So once the guarantee warranty for that equipment is over, then also, they are liable to come and see that equipment why it is not working, and they are liable for repair or replacement. So only suggestion is, don't do this entire process of purchasing an EMC on a word of mouth. Better you make some MOU, memorandum of understanding, between the company person or the company, and you. So legally, if required, you can take some action against them, and you can ask them to come and do the things at the earliest. Let's see the step number 8. That is, prepare manual for the list of the diagnosis, then joint problems and conditions where physiotherapy can be helpful. So which are the conditions? As some of our seniors have described, womb to top, in a lifespan, the physiotherapy is needed. So you can make a list of conditions where a physiotherapy treatment is required. So you can give it to your patient, their caregivers, or to the general people, and that will create awareness about the profession as well as about your clinic. Second, enlist the list of techniques which can be given by the physiotherapist. So you can give n number of techniques that this is what we are doing as a therapist. So you can make one manual for the same, and you can again use it for the awareness program or for the marketing program. And very important one which I liked is, make a do's and don'ts for the common conditions which you are treating at your clinic. For example, neck pain, back pain, shoulder or a knee pain. So enlist it properly, do's, don'ts, and you can do it with the precautions. Make in detail list, and then based on your specific diagnosis, like shoulder pain could be because of any problem to the skin, muscles, ligament, tendon, bursa, bones, joints, n number of problems. So based on that problem, what they have to do and what they don't have to do, you have to just mark, and you have to provide to the patient. You don't need to think and do the same process again and again. So this will help you a lot. And on the contrary, you can see one of my video in which, I had mentioned about free Android applications for physiotherapists. So in that, n number of exercises are given, and that same exercise, if you found it is appropriate and your patient has to do, you can send it through WhatsApp, SMS, email, and through the other routes. So prepare a manual. It is very, very much needed. Step number 9, make an arrangement for the followings. You can make a separate racks in your clinic, one for keeping all the stationary materials. So it can be your pen, files, old case reports, papers, whatever the things which is needed, related to the stationary, you can keep it in a one rack. Marketing materials, leaflet, brochures, cards, or any other material. Books, you can make a 3 separate track, one for the basic books plus regional language magazines related to our field, newspaper cuttings, etc. Book number 2, rack number 2, in that book 2, orthopedic, cardio and special technique books you can keep. And third, neuro, pediatrics, articles and medical or the other books you can keep it. And along with this, you can keep some of the soft copies of the book, which is nowadays very much circulated on the social media. You can download and you can make a DVD, or you can keep it in a pen drive, and that you can keep it into this racks. Of course, you can store it in the computer as well, but keep a backup so as and when required, you can get it immediately. It's really a good idea to make the things arranged, so it will be easy for you to run the clinic. My next step number is 10. 10 step number, it says, if you are interested to sell few of the things at clinic, make arrangement for the 3 separate racks for the same. Now, many of the therapists in the older times, and even right now, some therapists, they are selling along with the treatment, they sell some of the orthoses, some of the surgical items, etc. So two way it will be helpful to the therapist. One, it will create another source of income, and second, now because of the lack of times, patients don't prefer to go to the different places and purchase the item which you have asked for, and sometimes it will take a time, so it may affect the outcome of your treatment. So better is to you only provide and take a charge for the same. So what you can, like some of the examples you can provide about sandbags, incentive spirometry, surgical balloons, cool pack, hot water bag, thermometer, smiley ball, squeezing ball, any orthosis, silicone insole, cotton rolls, etc. So if you would like to sell anything, okay, there are anything which you can related to our field for the patient's benefit, you can sell. Okay, so this is also a good idea. Okay, many therapists are practicing this. Step number 11, that is, make three separate racks for utilities and supply. This will remain same irrespective of ortho, neuro, cardio or pediatrics your clinic is. Okay, one is for cotton, gel bottle, hand wash solution, adhesive tape, micropore tape, okay, plus etc. things you can keep. Another one, you can keep biscuits, juices, etc. items which is required for the refreshment. You can make a separate rack as a small reservation of the items which is required in the pantry section of your clinic. And the third one is your towel, napkins and other clothes for cleaning and miscellaneous items, plus anything extra you can keep it into this thing. Let's see the step number 12. Now, after opening a clinic periodically, not everything in the beginning, periodically you need to create awareness about what are the services you provide, and your clinic name should be on the mouth of the people, okay, meaning to surrounding areas. So for awareness, you can arrange bone mineral density camp and you can give exercise related to the osteoporosis. Second, you can do a diabetes mellitus screening camp, blood glucose level you can check and you can provide exercise which is needed in that patient because of diabetes mellitus. You can arrange for a free physiotherapy or fitness assessment or a treatment camp in an initial phase to attract the patients to your clinic, and then later on with your good quality treatment, patient will be keep on coming. And remember, patients are going to do the best marketing for you. They always follow the repeat and reference principle. That means what? They will come again and again. That we call it as a repetition. And reference means what? In their family, in their relatives, in their known people, they will be keep on sending the patient to your clinic. In a way, some of the patient will become your unpaid brand ambassador. So free physiotherapy or fitness assessment and treatment camp you can arrange. Diet assessment or the management camp along with the physiotherapy camp you can arrange at your clinic. Step number 13, always you have to keep this in your mind, okay, about the fixed and the variable expense. Don't only think about opening of the clinic, think about after opening you have to make out for the operational cost. There is a minimum cost for running the clinic. Okay, some are fixed and some are variable. Just suppose you have opened a clinic, electricity bill will remain the fixed. Okay, minimum bill is going to come irrespective of whether you are going to use it or not. Okay, phone bill. So some are fixed expense and some are variable expense. So keep this in mind, your light bill, rent of the place, maintenance of that place, servant, vera bill, that means what? Local tax, professional tax, mobile or a landline phone bill, physiotherapy assistant bill, okay, that means salary, utilities and supply bills, I have explained you about the utility, plus there are some miscellaneous expense that will come, and plus there are some unknown expense that will also come. So you have to keep this also in a mind, okay, before you start the planning. Okay, step number 14, okay, always keep the budget in a mind. Okay, if you have your own place or if you have taken on rent, keep this in your mind about the expense of interior of the clinic. Don't count the rent that, okay, 10,000 is the rent, so I will keep 60,000 reserve money for just for the rent so I can run for 6 months. No, this will be just the rent. Apart from this, maintenance, light bill, phone bill, okay, some part you have to spend on the interior, many more other expenses will come. So keep a budget for the expense for interior of the clinic, equipment for purchasing or updating, okay, you have to keep this in mind. Advertisement and marketing, periodically you have to allot some budget and you have to do this. And staffing, that means what? You can increase the number of staff, okay, or else you can increase the salary of the staff, and periodically you can arrange for some CME, CPE or a workshop, okay, this type of activities for you as well as for your stuff. So it's like sharpening of the axe. So then onwards you can work with the very efficiently. So keep some separate budget for the same. And my last and the important point is about the marketing or the advertisement for your clinic. Now this is also nowadays an integral component. Okay, so what you can do is a reference and repeat formula from the patient, a word from the patient, okay, or a positive feedback from the patient, it works a lot. That is the best advertisement. And the other advertisement methods could be newspaper advertisement, leaflet distribution, demo cycle or a demo van, bulk SMS service, digital marketing, social media marketing, vinyl, flex, standee or the canopy, which is nowadays commonly you can found at many of the places, Sampex, etc. And apart from this, you can think of making a website for your clinic. That you can go for a Wix.com, website planet.com, website builder.com, godaddy.com. You can go for the search engine optimization. That means anybody who is searching about you or your clinic in your city or a village, your name should come first. So for that, after making the website, you can use some keywords, okay, and you can go for some of the websites which will keep you up on the top of the page when somebody is searching about you. Because see, they say that in Google, if you type, for example, pain management, so n number of articles will come. Not all the people will see all the articles by clicking first page, second page, third page, up to the n number of pages. Most of the people, they will just see the first page. So your name should come first when somebody is searching about physiotherapy treatment or a physiotherapist in your area. So you can go for www.justdial.com, www.infoline.com, www.sulekha.com, www.indiamart.com, www.kurofi.com. Like that, many we have, you can make use of it. And of course, social media marketing is also now an integral part for marketing in almost all the fields. So you can think about doing marketing on a Twitter, Facebook page, LinkedIn, WordPress, Blogspot, Instagram, etc. And after doing this all, okay, very important is, okay, you have to think big and you need to make a good or a proper system for running the clinic. So there should be a system for registration, system for the fees payment, okay, book the appointment for the next treatment. For that, there should be a system. Okay, see, you don't need to do everything. You are as a therapist, you focus on the main thing. You just focus on the treatment aspect of the patient, like registration, collection of the money, okay, purchasing something, okay, from the outside for running the clinic. Let, you know, outsource this work to somebody and you focus on your core competency or the core technical expertise. So treatment, okay, make some protocols and follow that. And last is about the uniform or the dress code. Okay, so you can think about making a uniform or a dress code for yourself as well as for your staff, okay, clinical and the non-clinical staff. This dressing will basically, you know, give you that idea that you are a little different and you are employee of this particular organization. It gives a feelings of emotional bonding between the different people who is working in one setup. Second, it looks that this organization is systematic. And your logo on that particular, you know, t-shirt, okay, or the shirt, whatever it may be, it's like your holdings. Wherever your employee will go, okay, people will come to know that somebody from this organization has came. And another thing is, okay, it creates a good harmony between all the people as well. So if you found that, okay, it is good, you can implement this as well. Okay, so I hope this video will be helpful to you. You can be in touch with me. You can like this video. You can subscribe to my channel and you can be in touch with me. And you can share this video with the therapist who is in it.